Hi everyone, I'm back with another video, and we're gonna have to go through a quick guide on how to stuff a Jaguar, Mammoth, and Alligator Rush. Now here, this video is composed of two battles. First part would be the Jaguar Mammoth Rush, and then the second one will be the Alligator Rush. But of course, before we start, go on ahead, smash the like button, and of course, turn on the notification to all notifications so that you will not miss an uploader stream from my channel. Let's go ahead and begin. And here goes, the map will be the Hidden Trails, and we're gonna be up against Dr. Ahmad. Okay, now of course I'm gonna be at the bottom right, as can be seen in the map right here, going HQ level 2, and we're gonna have to go after those containers right there. Okay, now as we all know, this map is a resistance map given the landscape, okay, and then the distance plus the bushes, okay. Now, of course, you may have to scout and do not rush HQ level 4 for rank 21 below. Do not rush HQ level 4. Okay, but of course, I'm gonna have to produce some hammer. I need to get some intel on what he is up to. Now, of course, a barracks right there to prevent any rush, like grenadiers or anything like that. It will help discourage that. And yes, there goes the vehicle factory and a special vehicle factory going level 2. Now what does this tell me is that of course whenever there's like a vehicle factory level 2, a special vehicle factory level 2, then there are bound to be mammoths. Okay, now there's like a second special vehicle factory right there, four porcupines. Now of course I'll have Zeus, there's like a coyote scout right there, and I'm gonna have to produce some Zeus, of course, some Cyclone to detect infantries in the bushes. I'm also using a resource boost, of course, to speed up my base development. I will also have a Typhoon, of course, okay, because he will have dragonflies, and yeah, my premonition is correct. He'll go for a rush, and here he comes. He's gonna have to try and own me while I have less still. Okay, I only have one Zeus right there, or actually three Zeus at the moment. Okay, and that's not really soothing for me. And then there goes the Mammoth. Now, given this situation, you don't really have to attack right away and get rid of the Mammoth first. You know, save up your forces. Okay, just show him that you have something to defend, like that. Okay, show him that you have something to defend yourself with. And of course, given this scenario, I did. And I even destroyed one Jaguar and, of course, a porcupine or whatever. A mammoth, too. Okay, so that's actually very good. And I'm going to have to take my losses. Or no, I did not even lose anything there. He lost two dragonflies, some infantry, one Jaguar, one mammoth. And, obviously, I'm going to use a common recovery boost, of course, to stay or keep my units in a healthy HP, you know, have them in good health, you know, recover the HP that has been lost, keeping them alive, raising the value of that unit. Meanwhile, I'm going HQ level 4, of course, another Cyclone right there to detect the hidden infantries. Okay, again, scouting, and of course, going for a special vehicle factory level 3. Now, what does this entail is that, of course, I can tech up. So it's now or never, actually. Yeah, it's now or never. And I'll have to, of course, send some scout above the top of the map, or yeah, top of my base, to, of course, see if there will be any pending attack coming from that place. All right, we don't want to be surprised. Now, if ever you're under siege by mammoths, just given this situation, just go on ahead and do nothing. All right, just place your units on hold. In this situation, I managed to mess up and did not place my units on hold, so they chased after the attacking unit, which led to a meat grinder. Meanwhile, I'm taking up my base peacefully here on my end. He was not able to wait any longer and are impatient. And of course, I'm just gonna have to wait for my shield to pop up. You know, I'm not doing anything here in general though. Okay, so yeah, just letting him destroy my units. Okay, I'm just gathering my units right there, as you guys can see. Okay, and I'll have some assaults produced. Of course, there are like grenadiers, and those are annoying. Yeah. Barracks or bunkers has been destroyed. A barracks will be destroyed. And here goes the shield generator. Okay, now he has Jaguars, Mammoths, and some Dragonfly, you name it, whatever. Okay, and there goes the exchange. Okay, now, the problem is just that those Mammoths are firing at my shield generator, trying to destroy it. And as we all know, the Zeus are going to own the Jaguars, okay? Not only that, the shield will act as a force, you know, boosting the armor of your Zeus and reducing the damage taken from by your Zeus, and was able to take out all those Jaguars in one go. And of course, he's gonna have to try his best and retreat. But of course, given this scenario, that is a failed rush, and that will be the beginning of the end for him. Now, if the battle continued, he'll just get destroyed, because of course I have way tech. I have two vehicle factories. I can outproduce him and just snowball from there. And that's it. Basic. Alright? That's one of the given scenarios right there versus Jaguar Mammoth Rush in this map. Okay, and other similar maps as well. You may try and copy this, but of course scouting is key. Do not forget to scout. Alright. Now, moving on to the next battle, we go for an alligator rush, okay? Now, what this guy did was actually the right thing, okay? Just that the mistake was, instead of having two shipyards in two separate locations to gather the container, he had two shipyards on the top of his base, all right? Which is not a bad idea, but given this layout, his naval army is split into two. Alright, well, it depends on the intentions though, because he was going to try and attack me the top side. But yeah, we'll get to that later. But of course, we're gonna have to try and gather those containers around there as fast as possible, or as many as we can, to of course gain the upper hand. There it goes, collecting that container. And let's see now what will happen. And of course, we're gonna have to try and destroy as many, or annihilate those riflemen's, and there goes that Kaiman scout. Nothing really much he can do here. All right, now if ever he played for an alligator, it's too risky for him to do that, because I imagine that he himself is actually developing his base. All right, so he could not go for an alligator. And here goes, we're gonna have to try and deal some damage. He's actually quite good as to have a gun tower, because he is anticipating a delta rush. Well, I'm not going to delta rush anyway. Okay, and of course adding those supply centers, going HQ level 3, and he has an avia factory, so he can go hawks later on, but more likely given this scenario it will be for a dragonfly. Okay, now he is also going HQ level 3 as well, and as you know, that mistake, the mistake that I mentioned at the start, where he had two shipyards at the top of his base, basically that prevented him from gathering the containers on the right side of his base. So I got all that container. So now he is scouting right there. I imagine that he already has an alligator at this point. And of course, rushing an alligator, huge amount of alligator, like 5 or 6, 7, 8 and above, you need two shipyards for that. And for that, you need HQ level 3. Now on my end, I will be the defending side on this battle, or in this battle. So I'm gonna have to go for a Poseidon and try and annoy him, since I have the map or the ocean dominance here at the bottom side of my base. I have all that on my end. It's my territory. So I'm gonna have to abuse that power of mine and use a Poseidon that will be uncontested, protected by the naval platform, so no alligators can cross that. Now, as a means of scouting, I will have a cyclone, and of course, as a means of anti-air, I'll have a typhoon, generally because it is much cheaper than that of an anti-air. Plus, it is mobile. Okay, and there goes that Poseidon is trying to be annoying and are trying to destroy his gun tower. Okay, he also has a dragonfly, and I believe that he will be scouting me, and there goes, I'm gonna have to try and scout him as much as possible. I'll have those Vikings go out of those shipyards to help me defend, because I'm already anticipating that alligator. He has, like, let's see, let's count. I have 4 Vikings, 2 naval platforms, and my Vikings is acting like a meat bag for my platforms to have free fire, okay? So they have free hits, okay? So yeah, there goes. Count the alligators that he has. I believe he has 10 plus, and of course the newly produced alligators that are going to arrive in this location to, of course, reinforce the attack. Okay, now I lost all of my Vikings in this situation, but given the scenario, I have one more Viking that came out and another Viking, but of course I also am doing some damage. Now he really can't go on that narrow ridge right there at the top, because he'll end up losing some of his alligators, and of course I can just simply destroy that alligator in case. Okay, and there goes, of course, my other platform is within the range of those alligators. Oh man. And yeah, 2 alligators left, and I believe that he has more incoming. I'm gonna have to rebuild those platforms as much as I can, or as fast as possible, put them up right back, you know. And there goes another Viking, just popped out. Now, given the scenario, I'm going to produce the Viking at the second shipyard, or the first shipyard that I had, to, of course, avoid losing resources, because I'm expecting my shipyard to be destroyed. The other shipyard, that is. However, those alligators did not really perform well. Given the scenario, he'll be losing this battle. So, yeah. I mean, it is very evident that he's going for an alligator rush the moment he placed the shipyard on top and not attack your or contest your platforms at the start. So it's very, very simple. Alright, well, that's going to be it, and that's going to be that. Alright, so yeah, thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, go on ahead, smash the like button, and of course, turn on the notification to all notifications so you won't miss an upload or stream from my channel. Alright. Bye now. Victory.